Sources of Corporate Finance. We will study about shares and the various types of shares. We already have studied what is the meaning of share. Share means a unit, a part, a percentage, a bit of the entire share capital. Today, we will study the various types of shares. A company, it is issuing different types of shares based on income, the returnability, transferability, and rights given. So, income means the profits that the company is gaining. The returnability, the rate of return that is being got on the shares, that is the investment that takes place. The transferability, that is any public company, when it can transfer the shares, the shareholders can transfer the shares to another people, and the rights that are given to those type of shareholders. So based on this, we have different types of shares. Basically, there are two types of shares, equity shares and preference shares. Let us study what are equity shares. Equity shares are known as the long-term financing for any company. Here, these shares are issued to the general public, that is, the people who are going to apply for the shares. Companies Act, it defines equity shares as those shares which are not preference shares. So, as the word itself indicates, that which is not a preference, where these type of shares do not have any sort of prominence. These shareholders bear ultimate risk of the company. That is the reason these shareholders are called as the shock absorbers of the company. These shareholders are residual claimants of income and assets. So residual claimants means the income that is left after paying off all the direct and the indirect expenses. These shareholders attend the general meetings of the company. Only these shareholders, that is the equity shareholders, are allowed to attend the general meetings of the company. Let us now study the features of equity shares. Permanent capital. That is, this type of capital remains with the company as long as it is there. This capital is considered to be irredeemable, that is, it is not payable during the lifetime of the company. Therefore, it is called as long-term financing. It is payable only when the company closes down, that is, if the company is having enough of money to repay it back. Fluctuating dividend. The dividend of any equity shareholders depends on the profitability that the company makes. And so, when the company makes more profits, the dividend given also will be more. During any particular year, if the company makes less profits, then the dividend given also will be lesser. There are various rights that are attached to equity shareholders. They have a right to vote. They can attend the meetings, that is the general meetings, and they can vote and decide the company's decisions. They have a right to share in the profits. That is, when the company makes profits, whatever is the balance amount that is left, these shareholders have a right on those profits. They have a right to inspect books. The various books, that is the statutory books or the books of accounts, the equity shareholders can come and inspect those books. They can also apply for a copy of certain books. Right to transfer shares. So, an equity shareholder can transfer the shares of his company. But this facility is given only to the public limited companies. No preferential rights in respect of dividend and capital. Equity shares do not have a preference. That is, whenever the company is going to earn profits, these shareholders will get the dividend. Similarly, when it comes to repayment of the capital, these shareholders do not have any preference. Controlling powers. These shareholders are known as the real masters because they remain with the company during the highs and lows of the company. Therefore, they are known as the controlling power. they also decide the fate of the company. Therefore, it is said that equity shareholders can make or break the company. They have voting rights. That is, these shareholders can vote at the annual general meetings. They can attend the annual general meetings and they can vote over there by the various methods of voting. These methods of voting we have studied in 11th standard. Risk. Equity shareholders are known as the shock absorbers because they bear the maximum risk. When the company does not earn enough of profits, at that time these shareholders get marginal dividend. And whenever the company is going through any problems, at that time these shareholders remain with the company. Therefore, they are known as the shock absorbers to bear the maximum risk that the company faces. Residual claimants. That is, when the company earns profits, they are the last to claim over here. So, the company pays off all its direct, indirect expenses, reserves, and when the balance amount that is left, that is being given to these shareholders. And so, they are known as the residual claimants, that is the last to earn the claim on the company's profits. There is no charge on the assets. If the company is going in losses at that time, or if at all the equity shareholders have to be repaid when the company is going to be winded up, at that time the company cannot sell off its assets and pay off these equity shareholders because there is no charge on the assets against the equity shareholders. Bonus issue. That is, free shares are given as a gift only to the equity shareholders. Whenever the company has bonus, or we can say when the company is having reserve fund, extra accumulated profits, and they have to be capitalized, that is, it has to be converted into equity shares, at that time these shares are given as a gift, that is free of cost, only and only to the existing equity shareholders. Right issue. That is a priority that is given to these shareholders. Whenever the company is going to have a new issue, that is, the company wants to issue new shares, new equity shares in the market, the first priority is given to these shareholders. And so, if these shareholders are interested to purchase these shares, first they will be offered it. And these existing equity shareholders purchase these shares. Face value. The price is usually very low, that is rupee 1 or rupees 5 or rupees 10. Market value. The market value depends upon the demand and supply forces. Therefore, when a company is very good, at that time the market value of the shares is also very nice. The entire share market depends on the market value, that is how the shares have been traded in the market. And so therefore, the equity shares market value is very, very important. Capital appreciation. The company's goodwill decides the market value. And so, when the company is doing good, that is when the company is making very nice profits or it is having a fabulous sales, at that time the company's goodwill increases. And so, when this happens, the market value also increases of the shares. In the stock market, there is a capital appreciation, that is the shareholders' assets that is there, that is these shares, the value immediately increases, and so we call it as the capital appreciation. And so this capital appreciation decides as to how much it is going to increase the market value of the shares. Now let us study the types of equity shares. There are two types of equity shares. First, equity shares with normal voting rights. That is, the voting that are given to these equity shareholders are according to the number of shares that they hold. For example, if these shareholders have 500 shares, then they have 500 voting rights. The next we have, that is equity shares with differential voting rights. So, these shares that are there, that is equity shares with differential voting rights, have limited voting rights. And so, these shareholders might be offered an extra dividend. Equity shares with differential voting rights may have different voting rights or no voting rights. So all this is as per the rules 4 of companies, that is share capital and debentures rules 2014. So a company is issuing these type of debentures when the person is not interested or may not be able to attend the general meetings of the company. And so such people may be given an extra rate of dividend. All this depends on what is being mentioned in the articles and memorandum of association of that particular company. Let us now understand the next type of shares, that is preference shares. Preference shares means those shares which have a priority or preference over equity shares. These shares carry a preferential right in respect of dividend and capital. That is, these shares are given dividend before the equity shareholders, and they also have a preference in getting back the capital, that is the repayment of capital that takes place. These shareholders receive a fixed rate of dividend whenever the company earns profits. That is, when the company earns profits, these shareholders will get the dividend. But these shareholders will receive a fixed rate of dividend, whatever be the earnings that the company has made during that year. These shareholders do not have normal voting rights. That is, they cannot attend the general meetings of the company and vote at those meetings. But they carry a preferential right in case of voting too. So these shareholders are allowed to vote if at all it is going to affect their any selling of undertaking or changing the rights of these preference shareholders. And so, if the company is unable to pay them dividend for certain number of years, then these shareholders are allowed to vote. Otherwise, these shareholders cannot participate in the general meetings of the company and decide the decisions or participate in the decisions that take place. These shareholders are known as co-owners, but they are not controllers. That is, they do not attend the general meetings of the company, and therefore they cannot vote at such meetings for the decisions participation. Therefore, these shareholders are only known as co-owners, because shares is a type of owned capital. And so they are known as co-owners, that is along with the equity shareholders. These shareholders are known as cautious investors, because they receive a fixed rate of dividend. That is, the people, that is the investors, who are interested in a fixed rate of dividend and are not ready to take up any risk, invest in these preference shares. Therefore, these shareholders are known as cautious investors. Now, let us understand the features of preference shares. Preference for dividend. Equity shareholders get their dividend, but not before dividend is paid to the preference shareholders. And therefore, these shareholders, that is the preference shareholders, they receive the dividend before the equity shareholders. Preference for repayment of capital. If at all the company is going to be liquidated, that is, it may be closed down. At that time, after all the liabilities are paid off, then preference is given of repayment of capital for the preference shareholders. Therefore, they have a priority for repayment of capital. Fixed return. A fixed rate of dividend is paid to the preference shareholders. This is given only when the company earns profits. If a company is unable to earn any profits during that particular financial year, then the directors may decide not to give them dividend. And so these shareholders will get dividend only when the company is earning profits. Nature of capital. This type of capital is usually not permanent, as it is repaid after a certain period of time. For example, there are the redeemable preference shares. That is, this capital that is gathered by way of redeemable shares, that is where the company is going to repay back the capital, repay back the preference shareholders after a certain number of years. and therefore this capital, that is the preference shares, are issued only after a certain number of years, that is when the company is in need of additional capital for its internal purposes. At that time the company issues these type of shares, and therefore this does not remain for a longer period in the company. The company pays back this capital after a period of time. Market value. These shares are not traded in the share market, therefore the question of market value does not arise. These shares cannot be traded like the equity shares. So the whatever is the face value or the issue value remains itself as the market value. Voting rights. There are no normal voting rights. That is, the preference shareholders cannot attend the general meetings of the company and participate in the decision making. They can vote only if it is going to affect their rights, that is the dividend and capital returns. And so these shareholders are not allowed by the companies to vote, and therefore their rights regarding the dividend and capital returns is very limited. Risk. These shareholders do not face any risk. It is a boon during depression. So it is because that these shareholders are cautious investors. They prefer to purchase preference shares because they know it that these preference shares have a fixed rate of dividend, and therefore it is a boon, that is to the investors. It is a blessing for them because they will get at least a minimum rate of dividend. Face value. The face value is more as compared to equity shares, that is in the value of rupees 100 or 150. Rights or bonus shares. Unlike the equity shareholders, these preference shares do not have any such facility of rights shares or the bonus shares. These shareholders do not receive any free shares, that is the bonus shares, nor are they allowed to participate in the extra issue of the capital. Cautious and conservative shareholders only invest in these type of shares, and so the people who are preferring to have a safety investment, such people invest in the preference shares. Let us now study the various types of preference shares. Cumulative preference shares. Cumulative preference shares refers to those preference shares wherein dividend of the past years is paid in the present year. And so cumulative, as the word indicates, means wherein accumulation of dividend takes place. So cumulative preference shares are given the dividend of the past years in the present year. Non-cumulative preference shares. These preference shares do not carry any dividend of the past years. Dividend of the past years is not going to be given in the present year. They are only given the dividend of the present year. Due to any reasons, the company may not have been able to give them dividend for the past years. Cumulative preference shares have a right in the present year, whereas non-cumulative preference shares do not have a right over the past year's dividend that is accumulated. By default, all preference shares are non-cumulative preference shares. Participating preference shares. Participating preference shares refers to those shares which are participating in the extra profits of the company along with the equity shareholders. Whenever extra profits, that is extra dividend, is given to the existing equity shareholders, participating preference shares also receive a part of that particular profit that is given to those shareholders. Non-participating preference shares means those shares which get a fixed rate of dividend as has been decided. They do not participate in the extra profits of the company. Convertible preference shares. Convertible preference shares refers to those shares which are converted into equity shares after a certain number of years. Therefore, convertible preference shares, that is when these shares are going to be converted into equity shares, those shareholders get all the rights that are applicable to equity shareholders. After a certain number of years, the convertible preference shareholders are asked if they would like to convert their shares into equity shares. Non-convertible preference shares, that is those preference shares which are never converted into equity shares after a certain number of years. And therefore, these shareholders will be having a fixed rate of dividend and are going to carry none of the rights that are applicable to the equity shareholders. They will remain as preference shares lifelong. Redeemable preference shares. Redeemable preference shares means wherein the capital, that is the preference share capital, will be redeemed back. Redeem means to pay back after a certain number of years. Therefore, preference shareholders will be redeemed back their capital after a certain number of years. Redeemable preference shares are redeemed back their capital, not like the other preference shares where they may remain with the company lifelong. And so it is pre-decided as to when this particular amount of shareholders will be repaid back. And so redeemable preference shares are those shares which are going to be redeemed after a certain number of years. Irredeemable preference shares. Irredeemable preference shares means those shares which are never going to be repaid back during the lifetime of the company. When the company is going to be closed down, at that time they may be given back if the company is going to have enough of money to pay them back. These shares are not now into practice as per section 55(1) of the Companies Act 2013. These are the various types of preference shares that a company may issue as per their requirement.